Greetings. Strong planetary foreshadows indicate a high potential for a magnitude 7 to 7.5 earthquake event during October 11 through 15 that highlight the important planetary opposition of both Neptune and Venus. This will be an October forecast covering the planetary influences that will be in play and the potential for major geophysical events felt here on the Earth based on these influences from above. Now, these videos will be made on a monthly basis on this channel, and I will be covering the major geophysical events to watch with specific locations in mind. We're now focusing on the important astronomical events that will be taking place in October 2025. Venus will reach perihelion on the 2nd of the month, its closest approach to the Sun for the year. The important lunar perigee takes place on the 8th. The Moon-Jupiter conjunction will be quite powerful on the 13th. A very strong conjunction between Mercury and Mars takes place on the 19th, the same day as the Moon-Venus conjunction. The Moon-Mercury conjunction on the 23rd, the same day as the lunar apogee. And finally, towards the end of the month, Mercury reached greatest elongation on the 29th of October. We're now looking at the important planetary alignments that will be taking place in October. We get four geocentric alignments involving the Earth, and Venus will be quite powerful as it's reaching perihelion, and two planetary alignments involving Saturn and Neptune, all oppositions on the 11th and 14th of the month. The Sun will square Jupiter on the 17th, a very powerful time frame. And then Mercury will be quite strong the second half of the month, where it conjoins Mars and opposes Uranus on the 20th and 29th of the month. The important lunar perigee takes place on October 8. Now, it's a powerful time frame as it marks the Moon's sixth closest approach to the Earth for the year, and it will be moving closer and will be making supermoons in November and December, so their lunar influence will be quite strong the second half of October. We're now looking at the important Moon-Jupiter conjunction taking place on October 13, so the time frame from October 8 through 13 will be highly significant in terms of celestial and lunar influence. Now, the important aspect with the Moon-Jupiter conjunction, as the previous two significant earthquakes occurred within 44 and 51 hours of the Moon-Jupiter conjunction, both at Drake Passage, and there may be another earthquake to come in October, and more specifically in March of 2026 could see another earthquake event for the region. Now, the Saturn-Neptune influence is still quite strong, as they were close to converging in July and now moving retrograde, but importantly they are still close together in the zodiac, and that allows other planetary aspects to move and form an alignment, and we get some very powerful convergence of the planets from October 11 through 14 as the Earth moves in between a series of planetary oppositions which involve Saturn on the 11th and Neptune on the 14th of October. Now, I do feel that the month of October potentially may be another earthquake event for the Drake Passage, and the main reason is if we look back at the previous two earthquakes this year, magnitude 7.4 on May 2nd and magnitude 7.5 that occurred on August 22nd, sharing an interesting symmetry with the planetary stations of Pluto back in 2020 and 2022. Now, we have another planetary station of Pluto which is yet to produce a major event, and I do feel that this could be an even larger event to come as it sits on an amazing longitude line and connection and conjunction of both Jupiter and Saturn, which took place late in 2020. So I do feel that there is another event to come for the region, potentially further eastward towards Falkland Island, South Shetland Island, or the bottom end of the Drake Passage, and even in towards Scotia Sea. This would be something to watch in the month of October and potentially even into March of 2026. Now, the important aspect with both Drake Passage earthquakes, they share a very interesting symmetry that can't be ignored. Neptune made a conjunction with Venus at the time of the first earthquake. Note that the position of Neptune and Venus was at 1 degree at the time of this quake, and then Neptune went retrograde in July and reached the same degree point, and we get the second earthquake on the 22nd of August. Now, Neptune will complete its retrograde late 2025 and then return back to the 1 degree aspect in March of 2026. We're now looking at an exact chart made on the 14th of October 2025 and why it represents a strong earthquake potential here on the Earth. Not only does it mark the Venus-Neptune opposition, but importantly there are other aspects that are going to amplify the events on this time frame. Key things to watch would be the Mars position interacting with the lunar nodes, almost a perfect trine aspect over the next 24 hours. But importantly, the foundational driver and grand trine aspect of Uranus, Venus and Pluto will be kicking in during this time frame as well. And importantly, Pluto will be reaching station. So this may be an ignition point and release for a major quake when you consider that Venus and Neptune mark the first Drake Passage earthquake. This is the opposition and may represent the third earthquake for the region in 2025. We now get confirmation of the 2021 total solar eclipse of a future disturbance to come for the region, as it marks the Falkland Islands as a potential location for a future event. And importantly, the Falkland Islands is also featured with the Jupiter-Saturn conjunction of 2020 and also the Pluto station of 2023. We're now going to be focusing on the New Zealand region, specifically the North Island, for a potential event during the same time frame of October 11 through October 15 due to some very strong symmetry with the Venus-Neptune connection. We're now looking at the New Zealand region as it represents a possible foreshadow for the Venus-Neptune opposition. If we look back in November of 2023 and map the planets to the Earth, they are across the New Zealand North Island, specifically Lake Wairarapa, stretching in towards Whanganui, and further up north towards the Taramaranui region. So this may represent a future earthquake area to come. And if we have a look closely at this chart, not only do we have Venus and Neptune at opposition, but we also have Sun and Jupiter at opposition during this day as well. We're now looking at the 14th and 15th of October with astrocartography and focusing on the New Zealand region, and note that the Venus-Neptune opposition is taking place as well as the connection of Sun and Jupiter. The previous image we have Sun and Jupiter at opposition with the planetary alignment and opposition of Venus and Neptune. This time we get the Sun and Jupiter square aspect. So we get a double convergence of the same planetary alignments back in 2023 connected back into 2025. And that's not enough, Uranus is connected perfectly into this planetary alignment at trine. So this is a further amplification. And the previous image, Uranus was 4 degrees separate from this alignment. This time we get it perfectly in October, which is a worry. And it may represent a kicking off point or a closing of the circuit and a release for this major quake to come. There were two major earthquakes that struck the Wairarapa region in 1942. These earthquakes occurred in June, a magnitude 6.9, and in August, magnitude 6.8, two major earthquakes striking the North Island. If we go back 2 years prior, we get this same planetary alignment. Venus and Neptune were at opposition, if we map them geodetically to the Earth, very close to the earthquake epicenters. And I feel that this could be a hypersymmetry of what's to come, as this represents the same symmetry of the 2023 opposition of Venus and Neptune and a potential earthquake to come in the month of October 2025. In conclusion, I do feel that the period of October 11 through 15 could see a major earthquake event. Now, I have highlighted the Drake Passage region for a future event, and it is featured in my October newsletter. So for those interested, please visit the links in the description box or the solarwatcher.net website for more information. That concludes this video. I'm concerned of a strong event, and I will be uploading these on a monthly basis for those interested, highlighting the main area of focus, and more information can be found in the newsletter. Thanks for watching.